see, all praise be to the Creator, all power to his people. In the name of Yahshua, the Black Revolutionary Messiah, I greet you, my brothers and sisters, in the spirit of truth and the words of peace. Shalom Aleichem. Giving a special salute to the Black Messiahs, our motto is stop waiting for a Savior and be one. Stop waiting for a Savior and be one. This morning, coming from the scripture, the gospel according to Matthew, starting chapter 21, starting with the 9th verse. Matthew 21, 9th verse. And the multitudes went before and that followed cried, saying, Hosanna to the Son of David. Blessed is he that comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the name of the highest. And when he was come into Jerusalem, all the city was moved, saying, Who is this? And the multitude said, This is Jesus, Yahshua, the prophet of Nazareth, of Galilee. And Jesus, Yahshua, went into the temple of God, cast out all of them that sold and bought in the temple, and overthrew the tables of the money changers and the seats of them that sold doves, and said to them, It is written, My house shall be called the house of prayer, but you have made it a den of thieves. Dealing with the subject this morning, time to turn over the tables. Time to turn over the tables. Now, this is a pretty familiar scripture when Yahshua was coming into Jerusalem and the people were saying, Hosanna, Hosanna, because they were looking for a Messiah to save them. Hosanna means save us now. See, we say these words, but a lot of us never take time to realize what it means. Hosanna means save us now. So we see Yahshua going into the temple because during that time, Hebrews or Jews from all over would go to the temple. And his first order of business, according to the scripture, he saw the money changers and he turned over the table, saying, It is written, My house shall be called the house of prayer, but you have made it into a den of thieves. Time to turn over the table. Now, many of us read scriptures in Sunday school when we are 5, 6 years old, but we never take the time to go back and ask ourselves, what do the scriptures really mean? What were they talking about? Now, we got to understand the definition of the money changers. Coming from Holman Illustrated Bible Dictionary, defining what the money changers were, persons whose profession was to sell or exchange Roman or other monies for Jewish or Hebrew money acceptable in temple worship. In New Testament times, regions and cities issued their own money. This called the Jews of the dispersion that who lived outside of Judea to bring many kinds of money to Jerusalem to help visitors exchange money, and to the acceptable in Jerusalem, money changers set up in the temple court of Gentiles. Syrian silver coins were the money of Jerusalem then, and Worshippers used them to pay the temple tax of a half shekel and to buy sacrifices for the altar. It also says such transactions were numerous and required the service of brokers who knew the value of foreign money. Some exchanges profited greatly and loaned their money along with the others invested with them. Their interest rates ranged from 20 to 30% per year. So the thing about the money changers is they knew the value. They knew the value of the money, and other people didn't. They knew the value of the exchange. The other people, some of the Jews or Hebrews, did not know the value, so they were cheated. That's the same thing with our culture, brothers and sisters. That's the same thing with our culture. We don't know the value of black culture. We don't know the value of our history. So the money changers who know the value of black culture better than you do, better than we do, have cheated us, have stolen us. They've turned our history and our culture, our sacred culture, into a den of thieves. A den of thieves. Everything black people in this country have had going on, white folks, the European, have stolen it, misused it and abused it, and cheated us out of it. Some things they outright just took, like us, when they took us from Africa. But the wise of them cheated us out of it. They cheated us out of it. They stole our history. They stole our history. They told us the people of Egypt and Kemet, who were contributed greatly, were the founders of civilization. The Greeks, then the Romans, stole Kemet or Greek or Egyptian culture from Kemet. Read this book, Stolen Legacy, by Dr. George G.M. James. It goes into it. So they stole it. Then they told everybody that the people of Egypt or Kemet were white. Were white. They've stolen everything. They went into the pyramids. The French and the English. They had a competition. And they raided the pyramids. They stole the sciences. They stole everything from that era. They even stole our religion, brothers and sisters. They told us that the black Hebrew Israelites, ain't no way they could have been white. The Jews of that era were white. Ain't no way they could have been white. They lived too close to the equator to be white. But they stole our religion and used it against us. They turned the people of the Bible, who were black people, told you they were white, told you your skin was a curse. And they used that to enslave our ancestors. So not only did they steal our history, they stole our religion as well. Religion as well. They took a black man named Yahshua, changed his name to Jesus, then painted him white and then told you that image was the Son of God. They took everything from us, brothers and sisters. Read From Babylon to Timbuktu by Rudolph Windsor. From Babylon to Timbuktu by Rudolph Windsor. Then they stole our culture. They stole our culture. In Africa, they took the drum when they came to enslave our ancestors so we wouldn't communicate. That was a precedent for them to steal our music. They also stole our music. They stole jazz. They stole rock and roll. They stole hip hop. And when it came to hip hop, they used it to destroy us. Yeah, they did. They profited off of jazz. They profited off of rock and roll. When it was Little Richard and others. Big Mama Thornton and others. Elvis and them. Pat Boone and them. Took rock and roll. Took our music. Called it rock and roll. And put a white face on it. Go back and watch the Five Heartbeats. But when it came to hip hop, an indigenous African art form, which had its roots, some would say, in the Caribbean, and of course going back to Africa to some degree, but basically an indigenous art form in this country. They took that, made millions of dollars off of it, and converted it into an instrument of our destruction. So when hip hop first came out, it was about partying and having a good time, with some exceptions. Because was there drug use talking about getting high and getting skeed in early hip hop? Yeah. But then it began to mature around 1988 into something positive. Something positive to uplift black people from 88 to 92. But in 92, when the masses were waking up, they turned the conscious hip-hop, the positive hip-hop of Public Enemy, Boogie Down Productions, and others, X-Clan, into what they call gangster rap. They took gangster rap and started talking about how to murder black people. Had you all convinced you were the N-word. Then they had various different forms that they called in different areas, in L.A. and in Chicago, they started calling it drill rap, drill music. Music made and grafted and crafted for our brothers and sisters right around shooting each other and to make that seem normal. They have turned evil into making it seem fair seeming using our culture. Using our culture. Read this book. And I wrote the last chapter of this book. The Psychological Covert War on Hip Hop by Professor Griff. It'll tell you about that. So they stole our culture, brothers and sisters. They stole our culture. Everything about our culture they have stolen and used it against us. Even when it's coming to our fight against critical race theory. Started off, we were talking about black history. We were talking about black history and how we need black history in schools. But if you notice in the last couple of weeks, they've taken black out of it. And they used it to push their own white liberal agenda. They were talking about initially, and we were fighting about critical race theory. And we were using that to say, yeah, you've lied about black history. But the white liberals, as they always do, because the liberals and the right wing have stolen from us. Both of them have stolen from black people. They just do it and did it in different ways. But now they've changed the critical race theory argument. They're taking blackness out of it. And they're pushing their own agenda. Watch how they stop talking about black people in the critical race theory debate. And they start talking about every other people. Every other people. So we got to be wise, brothers and sisters. We got to reclaim our history. Reclaim our culture. Reclaim our religion. And reclaim our music. We need a cultural revolution. And as Dr. John Henry Clark taught us, go look in the mirror. Go look in the mirror and say to yourself, I plan to change the world. And I plan to do it right now. Right now. As always, we leave you with the Black Messiah motto, stop waiting for a savior and be one. Shalom.